Hello and welcome to India Today, India Tomorrow, this special series where we connect generations to get a slice of a changing India. And today we are joined by two very special guests once again. Please welcome the legend of cinema in South India, Mohan Babu, and his daughter Lakshmi Manchu. Thank you both very much for joining me here on India Today, India Tomorrow. You have done what? More than 500 films? Do you know how many films you've done, Mohan Babuji?
More than 560.
You started off as a villain, much like Shatrughan Sinha. You started off as a villain, became a hero, and then became a character actor. There's a little bit of Shatrughan Sinha in you then.
He's a good friend of mine, Shatru. Shatrughan Sinha means I used to call Shatru. And Mr. Dasanarayan Rao ji only introduced me as a villain, as a comedian, as a character role, and as a hero also.
And what was your favorite? Did you have was there a bit of the villain in you? Did you like yourself as a comedian or hero? What was your favorite character?
I like villain character. Ravanasura I like. Duryodhana I like. If you think they are villains, I like that.
You like to play a villain. You like acting as a villain.
Mm. You see, villain have chance to act different type of dialogues, different type of so many things. Hero only duets, only one or two pictures, good pictures, stories. Other, see my movie like a Pedaraidu. Villain can tell the dialogue different manner. The hero only songs, fights, that's all.
I'll come to this hero versus villain in a moment, but here you are. You're the archetypal heroine and you had to live under the shadow of a father who had done these 560 odd films. Was that additional pressure? Because you went through an entire different journey. He started off as a physical education teacher. You actually went to film school, went to Oklahoma and studied film in a completely different world to the world that Mohan Babu started off in Chennai in the 1970s.
True that. I had to unlearn what I had learned when I had gone there.
Your entire journey is very different to your father. You started off at the Oklahoma Film School.
Well, long story short, in the South, it is not so accepted for a hero's daughter to come into the industry. It's okay if you were an actress's daughter, but not an actor's daughter. And my dad always feels bad that we all became actors. He says, there's too much struggle in the film industry, you know. But I said, the apples don't fall too far from the tree. We all three are in the same industry. And it's still a struggle for me to understand why I was treated differently because I'm a woman. But I didn't have the guts to tell my dad. And so I went the furthest the way I could, and that was America. And even when I was in school, I told him I was doing computer science. He had no idea that I was doing theater. But, you know, I knew my conviction was really strong, and I knew I had something deeply rooted that this is what I had to do, and I had to go with my instinct that made me move away from home and find that dream. Wherever, if it was Timbuktu, I would have gone there, I guess. But that was why I went that far, only because there wasn't an opportunity here. Times have changed. Now here we are holding the torch and changing that around.
So Mohan Babuji, you had no problem your daughter acting in films. Your sons were acting in films, Vishnu and Manoj act in films. But your daughter acting in films, Lakshmi, did you have a problem with that? Or were you okay? You wanted all your children to become actors.
See, they have chosen the life. Lakshmi, I never expected she will come in this line. First I wanted to, she will become a housewife, and my elder son Vishnu, he's a good basketball player. I wanted to make him as IAS officer or IPS officer.
You didn't want them to become actors?
No.
Why?
And only Manoj, he must become as a hero. But knowingly, unknowingly, God blessed them, they have chosen, they are successful, they are very well disciplined, they are successful in the line. I'm happy.
You're happy today. But when she first decided, what, you decided to become an actor, what was his response?
I didn't tell him only. He didn't know.
You didn't even tell him?
Yes.
He didn't even know when I was acting in America. I was on these leading shows called Las Vegas, and I was on the Boston Legal, Desperate Housewives. I was doing a lot of independent film there. I was too scared, because if I had shared that, and if he said no, that's disappointing him. We don't want to disappoint our daddy.
And one day you tell him that actor Nalarthatanu conduct chesadu, I came there without
dad.
Telling you.
Yeah, yeah, tell me the story.
So my dad didn't know I was acting, but he slowly got to know from people who saw me acting, his friends, and said, oh my God, your daughter's in Hollywood. And he's like, yeah, because he had no clue. And then my mentor, Richard Lawson, he was directing a play with me, and my dad coordinated with him, and my dad showed up on the opening night of the theater where Baby's Dance was the play. And after the show, I saw him and I was like, I can't even explain what went through.
I traveled from here to there without telling her.
Yeah.
And I went, I have seen. His mentor is a wonderful actor also, you know.
Richard Lawson.
Ah, and
what was your first feeling? Because, you know, here you are, the hero of films and the villain of films in Tollywood and Kollywood. Chennai and Hyderabad is one thing, but Hollywood is a completely different world. So what was your first feeling when you see your daughter acting in serials in the United States?
It was shock, sir. Really shock. Surprising, my daughter is acting, and acting Lakshmi, but how the character she is playing. First it was shock, then I am observing this girl is playing the correct role or not, correct expressions or not.
Then he became a critic immediately.
Oh, he became an immediate critic.
Critic.
Are you telling me that you learn acting better in Chennai and Hyderabad than they learn in Oklahoma or in Los Angeles?
Always South India better than that. Oklahoma.
Better than them?
Yes.
South India better than Hollywood?
Our India is the better acting than that. I won't. We are better actors in
India. You all are natural actors.
Yes.
Do you agree with that? Or did you consciously want to break away from the world of Telugu and cinema in Madras and move?
I consciously wanted to break away from bigotry and sexist kind of environment that I was in. I wanted to get away as far as from India as possible and Indians. Because
it, really?
Yes.
You felt that our environment is sexist, is anti-women.
Very suppressive. But I still feel that.
You still feel that,
yes.
Having come from the US now,
even
back
more
to...
so. Nobody ever judged me in America, for the especially where I was, in spite of being in a very southern state, in the Christian belt of Oklahoma. I never felt different than I feel now, because they're like, you're Mohan Babu's daughter, what's wrong with you? You know, why are you doing this? You've learned that. So I'm like, I'm treated not for who I am, but from where I come from. And America taught me who I was for what I am, not because where I came from or, you know, the legacy that I carried or any of that.
But yet at the end of the day, Lakshmi, you made the journey back to India and you chose first to be in Telugu talk shows. Now you act in cinema. So you took the reverse journey. You could have stayed on in Oklahoma. You could have stayed on in Los Angeles.
My luggage is still there in LA.
Your luggage is still in LA? So what made you come back?
My brother's wedding. It was a simple story. We were having a discussion like this with some TV heads. And I said, you know, when I want to grow older, I want to do a show like Oprah. Like, she's God to me, right? Mm-hmm. She really inspired me in many ways. So that was during his engagement. I come back for his wedding and the show is on, it's an okay for the show. And I'm like, I didn't even speak Telugu that well then, you know, because I was raised in Chennai. So we learned Tamil. I was here for my inter 11th and 12th, where hardly anybody speaks Telugu in Hyderabad. It's mostly Hindi and mm-hmm. English. And so here I am coming back after like 10 years and they said, you want to do a show in Telugu? And I said, Vishnu, I cannot even speak the language. He said, what do you care? They said, yes. And you will learn on the job and you make some money and go back. I said, this is fabulous, because he had just gotten married and I love the whole Indian feel of being together. And cut to, here I am sitting with you.
So you became a Telugu opera for a while.
Yes,
and then the next thing you know is you get cinema roles and you're moving from one cinema role to the other.
Yes.
I'm just wondering, when I come back to it, and you know, this is where you said your role as a villain. What is it that you learned in the natural acting that you talk about the Chennai film industry? When you say that you learn much more in India than you do in the West, what is it that you learned? What did Dasari Narayan Rao teach you?
Slowly, where you are taking me, I know that.
No, I'm asking
but
you.
But anyway, what do you question?
My question is, what did Dasari Narayan Rao teach you? How do you said that you learnt that India is a much better place to learn cinema than the West. What did he teach you?
Sir,
he's a because you had no training in acting.
No, sir, he's a great man. See, he used to tell me the dialogue. He used to tell dialogue. I used to follow Mr. N.T. Ramaraoji, the diction. Then I used to see his movies from the childhood. And then he used to tell me, Mr. Dasarangan Raoji, where the dialogue up and down, where to raise, where to slow, what is this? He used to tell me for every dialogue. I used to follow, I used to catch. Then I use my own style.
Give me an example, how you would do it. One famous dialogue of yours.
I'll ask him the best way to do it. I've seen my dad change a scene in a dubbing room. Like what he shot to what, when it comes to the dubbing studio, he'll sit there and change your life by just how he will tune that scene differently. So, Nanna, give an example of normal ga cheppadam and infliction tho cheppadam.
See, one fellow I was played in M. Dharmaraju MEA, I played as a villain role. Villain means he's the hero, almost a dual role.
Anti-hero.
Anti-hero. Old man, old get-up. And in the character says, his name is M. Dharmaraju M.A.
Right.
That Dharmaraju says, not Pandava Dharmaraju, right. This character Dharmaraju.
Right.
He will call one servant. He is so many years he is with him. He will, you go and kill him. In picture how
you
they...
You can say it in Telugu also.
How the picture he will say, yes. That Dharmaraju, hey, మీ అమ్మగారిని చంపేసి దట్ మీన్స్ కిల్ మై వైఫ్ యూ కిల్ మై వైఫ్ మీ అమ్మగారిని చంపేసాయి హీ సేస్ అయ్యా అమ్మ కదా హీ సేస్ షీఈ్ మదర్ మీ అమ్మ కాదు కదరా somebody. He will go. Then I will call. Ray. Okay, Tempa. That means, Ray, you go and kill my wife. He says, Aya, she's like mother. I tell him, she's not your mother. She's my wife. Kill her. He goes. Then again he will call, Ray, don't kill so many like this. Only once, Fasak, go. That is a dialogue. How slowly?
And using those expressions, putting expressions, your hands through
like
the hair.
That. Hey, go, kill. Now, soft man, go.
Like a mafia don.
He gives me goosebumps.
He's giving you goosebumps when you... And all this is original. All this comes from within. It's not the director telling you, right?
No. Director will tell. I will improvise. Like that, the one girl says, King character I played. Rajakiyam veeru, Rajaniti veeru. Rajakiyam, Rajula Navanadullo pravahistu untundi. Rajaniti, Puranallo padilinga untundi. That is the dialogue. Rajakiyam for kings will be there in everybody. Rajaniti, the justice, will be inside the books. That is a dialogue in Thandrapaparayana.
So do you believe, Mohan Babuji, good actors are born? Is it something that comes from within or are they made? Does the director make a good actor? All these gestures.
Director's participation also is there, sir. Without director, he can't become an actor.
But when a physical education teacher becomes this megastar, something was there inside you, obviously. These gestures, this voice modulation, it came from within. I'm told many Bollywood stars copied you. Shakti Kapoor. Is it true he copied you?
Yes.
What is the dialogue? Lalit.
Oh.
Oh.
Lalita.
Oh, say it again.
Oh. Lalita.
It was Shakti Kapoor who copied your villainy and your style.
You won't say copied, he came, he requested me.
Oh, he requested you. Yes. You had to train him.
Yes.
he came to listen to your dialogue and then simply went back and learned how to do it for Hindi cinema.
Same picture Telugu I did, it went, it ran 25 weeks that time.
He played his character in
Hindi. So I'm just wondering, Lakshmi, when you see him, and I could see you, as you said, you had goosebumps watching him perform. You know, this is a natural actor. He didn't need to go to Oklahoma school.
Yes.
I come back to it. As we look at India today, India tomorrow, do you believe that the new stars of your generation need to go to through the training? Or can they be natural stars like your father?
My father had the drive in him. He started as an assistant director. He was with Dasan Narayan Rao Garu. He spent time to learn, to unlearn. As he said, he taught him his every modulation, his every expression. Now you take that, I would think that that is teaching, that is learning, right? See, when you're a musician, you have to play your instrument for 7-8 hours a day. If you're a doctor, you have to continuously keep studying. You cannot build buildings without learning to be an engineer. How do you expect an actor to just show up and know what they learn? I think the times have changed. That is the tomorrow. You have to put in the hours, you have to learn how it's done. You need to know what makeup is, you need to know what wearing heels is, you need to know what dancing is and how much to show. And all of that learning has to be done. Gone are the days that you're being picked up in a coffee shop just because you're pretty looking. Because now India has a lot more pretty women that we see a lot because of the social media. The world is a very, very small place. You can't just be a pretty face and not have the chops to be successful.
Yes.
Sir, I speak Anama?
Yes.
Without father, mother will teach first the child. Here, we go in good pathway, this is a good pathway, this is the bad pathway. They will teach us from the childhood, like that. Yes. The director says, this is the dialogue, this is the expression, this is the character, like that. That always I say, the credit goes to the director. The success failure goes to the director. He is the captain, he is Radhasarathi, like a Krishna Paramatma.
Who is the better star though? Which generation produced the bigger stars? The NTR generation, the Mohan Babu generation, or the Vishnu, Manoj and Lakshmi generation?
The great NT Ramaraoji, Nageswaraoji, Sivajiti, Dilip Kumarji, and Kannada Rajkumarji, Prem Rajit, they are the top. We have learned from them.
What did you learn from an NTR? I am fascinated with NTR because both in politics and in cinema,
sir,
he was this.
He treats me like more than his brother. I have cassettes, he has spoken about.
Although we didn't share the same umbilical cord, we come from, though, although we're born for two different mothers, he's my own. So he's had a great love and affliction for daddy since he was.
What was the secret of, sir, the success of these megastars? You mentioned Shivaji Ganeshan, N.T. Rama,
sir, they're born actors. The discipline, decency, dignity. And from that I'll have learned, 7 o'clock shooting means 6:30 Mr. Shivaji Ganeshan or N.T. Ramarao Garu, Nageswara Garu, all the senior heroes, they used to sit whether director comes or not.
6:30 in the morning?
Yes,
yes.
It is
the
truth.
Let me tell you something else.
Even today myself.
Yeah, go ahead.
4:30, 5 o'clock there will be a sun shot from Madras to 60 kilometers, you must come. And Dasan Narayanaraju told Mr. N.T. Ramarao, 4:30 to 5. He was there 4:15, Mr. N.T. Ramaraoji.
So, that was,
so
there was a lot of hard work that was involved.
Yes.
There was, it was like going through a Agni Pariksha.
Yes, sir.
You know, going
Those
through
were
a
different
test.
Different times, Ji, because Nana, tell about the time where you say there was one makeup artist who was so good. In AVM studios, they would all stand in line, ANR Garu,
Pitambaram Garu.
They would stand in line for this one makeup artist.
Yes, his name was Mr. Pitambaram Ji. His son was one of the leading director, Tamil Nadu. That gentleman, MGR Ji makeup, MGR Garki, and Ramarao Ji, and Savitri, and Eswaranga Rao Garki, for so many heroines and heroes, he will go and finish shooting makeup between 3 to 6.
You know, I've often been told the technicians of the South, particularly the camera persons, the makeup artists, are much superior to those of Hindi cinema. Is that true or is that a myth?
See, I think that...
I will tell the truth.
Yes.
Yet, Amadu?
Are the makeup artists and the technicians superior in southern cinema to
let
that of
me
Hindi
tell
cinema?
But yes. If she says some controversial may come, but I don't care for that controversial. But the get-up, you say Rama and Ravana.
Yes.
You see Mr. N.T. Rama Rao pictures. What they are making in North India, you see the Rama Ravana get-ups. These are the original get-ups. South Indian, Karna, Duryodhana, Krishna, Mr. N.T. Rama Raoji, Nageswaraji, Shivaji Ganeshanji. The characters, Krishna, oh, Krishna Paramatma will be like this. Oh, Ravana will be like that. The get-ups, makeup mans, their challenge, their South India is better than
But
North.
You tell me, Lakshmi, from the age of your father to the age in which you act, what is it like today? How is it different from this golden age that he's talking about?
I think people take it too casually now, filmmaking, in the North, I feel. In the South, we still have the fear of, like, you know, Kalamatalli. She's the goddess of art. You pray every time you go on set. When there is a time given, you keep that time. You hear stories about superstars and are not showing up at the time that they wish to. How disgraceful is that? I mean, my dad would throw us out of the house if he knew we did that one day out of our lives.
And today you are able to, I mean, Tollywood, for example, a Bahubali made in yes. multiple languages is bigger than any Hindi cinema. So is Tollywood today aspiring to be as big as Hindi cinema? Because, you know, earlier when...
I'm going to correct it right there. We were bigger than Hindi cinema even from before. The only reason you didn't hear about a Telugu cinema is because of the language that's spoken only in this state. Hindi has a further reach. That's why Hindi cinema is played all over the country, because it's an official language. Not because it's any bigger or smaller.
You don't feel inferior to those who act in Hindi cinema. You don't think that...
Lakshmi, sorry to
You don't think that going to Hindi... You didn't...
No, I want to...
You didn't act in Hindi cinema.
She said
you didn't have it as
she
a goal.
She said something.
Yes.
The national language is not the Hindi. They are telling national language in Hindi, but they didn't accept in Rajyangam, constituency.
No, but it is written as an official language. English and Hindi.
No, but I'm asking both of you. Was it an ambition for you? You never acted in Hindi cinema. Instead, a Shakti Kapoor came to you to train how to play the role of a villain. You didn't think, I want to act in a Hindi picture ever?
Never, sir. Only once one director asked me, I told him, with the new actress he was taking. I said, sir, I want to act with the great actors are there in Hindi. I want to act with them. I must get name. Challenge, open challenge. Any language in the world. Today I'm telling it. I don't want to use a challenge, what word I don't know. I am ready to act and get extraordinary name. Any Oscar award or any award in the world, let them play a good role. Then the people comes.
So you are ready to act in Hindi cinema, but it was not an ambition or goal.
No.
I want to make it big in...
Because
today you've got the likes of a Prakash Raj who will act in southern cinema, but will also act as a villain in Hindi cinema. Have you also thought that, is it an ambition that I must become a big star in Hindi cinema?
I didn't think Hindi, but I wanted to be an artist. My dream was to be an actor, to be an artist and to be able to tell stories. And that didn't matter if it was in India or in America. America gave me the opportunity to be able to tell those stories and open the doors for me. Now, coming back here, I don't differentiate. I'll do a Tamil, I'll do a Kannada, I'll do a Telugu, I'll do a Hindi, I'll do a Bengali, which I'm looking forward to because they make incredible film and storytelling that happens there. So, as an actor, you cannot say this is all that I will do. I want to do it all.
So, the language barrier has gone. As Bahubali has shown, you can do a film in multiple languages.
Sir, your question is... Your question is, sir, you said you want to act in Hindi, become a great means.
Yes.
Do you think if I act in Hindi, I will become a great? Already we are great. Yeah, acting in the Hindi picture only, I won't become a great. Already we are great.
So NTR for you is a bigger star than Amitabh Bachchan?
I won't say. I give respect to Amitabh ji. I won't say I'm a better actor than Amitabh.
No. N.T. Rama Rao garu.
N.T. Rama Rao, do you think N.T. Rama Rao is comparable to all the greats of Hindi cinema? Dilip Kumar?
Sir, giving respect to Dilip Kumar ji, Pran ji acted with me, and Amitabh ji also. I don't want to compare. It won't look nice as an actor, But I think Mr. N.T. Rama Rao type of roles, which nobody can play in India.
Before the break, we spoke of NTR the actor, but now I'm going to speak of NTR the politician, but importantly, the whole phenomenon of South Indian superstars becoming politicians. You also, Mohan Babu, were a Rajya Sabha MP for 5 years. Why is it that South Indian politicians are so keen to get into politics?
Sir, Sunil Ji also came.
That's true. But no one became as big as an NTR or an MGR. The phenomenon that we saw.
Or a Jayalalitha.
Sir. And now possibly Rajnikant as well and Kamal Hassan.
Sir.
What is this phenomenon? Why are you all so interested in politics?
Sir, why he means? Because we acted as a hero. It is a very different question. But the answer must understood, sir. I am speaking in English. Heroes we are playing in picture in good characters. Not every picture, some of the picture only playing dual role, the heroine, love scenes and fighting, like that. But most of the scenes, some of the pictures, they will reality stories, the village farmer characters, and like that from the roots, the good stories previously. And what is the poor people? What is the, like that, the character? He will be.
People would identify with your character. When they saw NTR playing the role of Krishna,
same thing, sir.
Or NTR playing the role of a poor person, the people would identify.
No. My answer, we know the roots from the poor people.
I see.
Because all Mr. MGR ji, Nageswar Rao ji, Rama Rao ji, Shivaji ji, all they came from farmers, from root level. They know the difficulty of the poor people. I am not talking about the North India. They know, that means when in the society some of the politicians cheating the poor, the poor people, then these heroes, why don't we become a chief minister, do justice for the people, like that Mr. MGR.
So they wanted to do justice for the poor,
yes.
Because they were identified with the poor, even their cinema was identified with the poor,
yes.
And they came from the grassroots.
Yes, sir.
You know, I'm just wondering, do you think Rajnikant will be a successful politician?
99%, because why I am telling 99%, as my 100% we are not supposed to say, because there is a God, he is a decided person. I feel 99% he will be success, 1% leave to the God.
You look a bit like Rajnikant, Mohan Babu, from some angles, no? Not necessarily, but
they
like...
They won't agree, you should see both
no, no,
of them.
No, if you say that fellow is like me.
Okay, I will say that.
He will copy.
He's a copy of Mohan Babu. But look, there is this world of cinema here, where cinema heroes here are much more than just film heroes.
Yes.
They are seen as larger than life.
Today, if you go into the houses in the interior parts of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, they still have N.T. Rama Rao Garu's photograph as Rama, as Krishna. To them, he became God and what he represented. All the mythological films were only done in the south then. Now you have in the north television that you see a lot of the Ramayanas and the Mahabharatas or the Puranas that are being made. But in that context, when cinema first came up, to see your God speak romance, love, and show you the ways of life, people immediately connected with them.
But you know, today, when you look at a Chiranjeevi or a Pawan Kalyan, they have not been able to achieve the instant success that an NTR did, or that the popularity that MGR had as chief minister, never lost an election. I'm just wondering, can today's stars achieve what an NTR or an MGR did, you think?
Of course they can, but you also have to realize people are not as naive as they used to be before. Everything is up in the open right now, you know? And so if you say something, people hold you accountable for it.
So it's more difficult now.
Very
difficult. Sir, 30 years back, politics was different. Mm-hmm. Mr. N.T. Rama Rao ji came 1982, I think.
Yes.
That time politics are different.
Yes.
And now this time politics. The people, I love the people. I came from the people. I came from the village. Now the people, most of the people, corrupted. When the people will take money from the
politicians,
when some of the fellows, he wants to stand as an MLA or MP, when they are paying money, if the person, voter, takes the money, then only he dead. Prajaswamyam dead.
So you think today's politics has got corrupted? In the NTR, MGR era, politics was not as corrupt as it is today, right?
Yes.
You did not have to pay money to become a politician.
Yes.
Right?
Even the people have lost their respect. Because if you take money from a politician for your vote, you have no right to ask the politician if something is not going right. If you don't take money, then he works for you as a citizen. But here,
and also
we can
say
that because in our school and colleges, mm-hmm. when there is elections happening, the gardeners don't come to work, the people cleaning, the cleaners won't come to work because they're taking money from all politicians, and they have a good holiday for 2 weeks.
No, particularly Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, it's become all about money. Is that the reason why you didn't want to remain in politics?
You said that in Gujarat.
No, it's become worse here.
Sir.
I'm told the scale is higher in Andhra Pradesh. To win an election today, you need crores of rupees.
For MLA, they are spending 200 crores.
For MLA?
MLA.
For MLA?
They are spending now. Next elections, I'm thinking, somebody told me, some of the MLAs, they want to spend 200 rupees. That means 200 crores. 200 crores they want to spend as an MLA because they will earn afterwards 2000 crores.
So therefore, is that the reason why someone like you eventually decided not to become,
what
you said,
God
Namaskaram?
Has given something, okay, sir, go. If at all I go, I don't want that money.
You don't want that money?
That money.
You think that in some way, is that why it's going to be more difficult for a Rajnikant or Kamal Hassan? They will have to change society. In Tamil Nadu, there is so much of money today in politics. It will not be as easy for Rajnikant as it was possibly for an MGR.
Sir, I wish them the success, but I don't want to speak about the money, whether they are going to spend or not, other than people will, I don't know about it.
But overall, in general, now that you've reached the end of your in a way, your career is in its last stage. Would you prefer to be remembered as an actor?
Take your word wapas, my dear friend, because...
You will never retire.
No retirement.
No retirement for an
when
actor.
When the God has given all the body, when the body works properly, when the people says he's a good, till that we must act. Before the people says, oh, we can't see this fellow, then before that you must retire. Now, I didn't retire because of my sons. I am not acting for so many years. Yearly one picture I am doing like that. But if you ask me age, as long as I am acting in the movies, my age is only 55.
I see. And if there is a film going on in one theater with you as a hero and your sons as a hero, who do you think people will go to watch? You or your sons?
First him. My sons will be at his movie only.
Yeah.
But I pray God they must go and see my son's movie.
But you want your sons to go do even better than you, right?
More than that.
You want them to do better than you.
Yes.
Has he always told you that, is there a sense? I sense a sense of pride in the fact that his children have also gone on to become actors and successful actors. Does he tell you that? What is the advice he gives you as a father?
The only advice he gives us is what you make is enough for you. Do not go beyond and above. Be true to your work. Be punctual. He's very, very, very critical about keeping a time and being disciplined, having accountability for your work, taking responsibility for everybody on the set. You know, my dad, one thing he always used to tell me, he said, if you have a beautiful mansion, is not enough. If there is garbage outside your house and the people living outside are living in stink, that smell is going to come into your house. You have to make sure the people living around you also have a good life. So make sure you have a good enough life to take care of the people around
you. So the spot boy, the camera people,
yes,
all of them are part of one large family,
yes,
in a way.
Yes, sir, no.
They have to be sort of treated with respect.
Absolutely.
And that's where the punctuality comes. I mean, this is not the Rajesh Khanna generation of superstars,
yes,
who would keep their actors waiting for... So punctuality and... What about money? Is money a driving force? Is that why you became an actor? Is that, is it all about money?
Huh?
No, that's a great question.
No, what?
Did you come into industry because of money, because there's good money? I still don't get paid what my father gets paid. Huh?
No, not that,
that's
sir.
Another fight.
Is there still that huge discrimination,
sir,
between men and
sir,
women?
Absolutely.
So your brothers will get always paid much more than you?
Yes.
No, sir. I have
to work all year long.
But money is not a driving force for you.
Absolutely not.
Did you get into cinema because of the money?
No, sir. I never expected I'm going to take money like that. I want only like a horse. I want to become a villain. I want to become a big actor. If I am walking on the road, everybody must see me. Hey, what a beautiful actor he is. That is the ambition. I want to earn money. I want to become a great... I never expected that.
You wanted to become a villain. You wanted to become a villain. Because what? You thought your face was that of a villain or why? Why did you want... You liked the idea.
I liked that.
You know, we started off this program by saying this, that you prefer, you believe a villain is a superior actor in a way to a hero.
Sir, in India,
yes,
I think I am the only one villain who played so many mannerisms like that.
Give me one more mannerism.
And see,
what is your favorite mannerism?
And like this, in the dialogue mannerism and the hand mannerism, sikkar me rakha, like that.
And would the audience clap for the villain?
Yes, then.
He's the only villain they would clap for.
The audience would clap for the villain.
I was in my college when we moved to Hyderabad, at college in the sense 11th and 12th grade. All my girlfriends would come home and just go like melt in front of my dad. It was like, because in Chennai we were raised like not
normal.
An actor's daughter. Only after coming here it's like a Mohan Babu's daughter. And then when they would come home, they would just...
And I played as a hero also. It was sensational hit. Pedaraidu.
Also, a lot of heroes didn't want him in his movies because he was too good looking.
So you would overshadow the hero.
I don't want to say that.
Yeah, but I
acted so many pictures in my banner, Silver Jubilee, Golden Jubilee, as a hero.
Let me ask you in conclusion, your ambitions, your dreams now. Let's start with you. What next? What is India tomorrow for you? What would you like to achieve in the next 10 years?
I think I've achieved what I wanted to. Now it's holding the torch and making sure it burns bright. I've always said I wanted to touch, move and inspire people with the art that I do. And God has given me a voice in television and in film. And really what has driven me so far in such a short time is when women come up to me and said, thank you for giving us a voice. It's not that I'm encouraging people to become actors, but encouraging them to speak up for themselves. And I think that is very, very, very important. And that is India tomorrow, to be able to speak up and not be suppressive to what the society says that you should be. We are what we are, no matter what the society says. So that's what I see in the future.
Sir.
Yes.
I have so many things, sir. The girl, whether your daughter or my daughter, or anybody's daughters, any girl, even 12 o'clock, what Mahatma Gandhi said, 12 o'clock she must walk alone. Then only we are great. Our politicians are great. Our India great. When there is no security for the girl, where is the talking so many things?
So your dream for India tomorrow is an India where your daughter and your sons can walk just as freely at 2 in the morning, anywhere in Hyderabad or Mumbai.
Any daughter, any woman, she must walk alone in the night with the safety. Yes, I can go from here to my theater, walk, I can see movie, I can go back to my house, I can see my husband or my parents. That there is no security here. When it comes, and then the poor is becoming day by day poor, the rich is becoming the rich. When it goes, then only the India will become number one. Next thing, I am afraid of, again, some of the countries may occupy our India because of the inefficient of some of the politicians. We may, what we are tomorrow.
But what I like is, all you southern big iconic heroes have views on politics, like you expressed just now. I don't see that very often in the Hindi film industry, which is why perhaps actors like yourself and the great actors who became politicians have this larger than life image. Remain the way you are, Mohan Babu. Keep acting. How many films are you going to act eventually? Have you set yourself a target? Like, you know, Virat Kohli wants to score 25,000 runs.
That ambition I am not having now, but my ambition, till that God has given me the good health and wealth, up to that I will play.
And you will continue to contribute in a way to society. Does he do much for overcoming this rich-poor gap? Do you do a lot of charity?
I will do it, my dear.
Let me tell this.
Yes. My
daughter is doing some of the fantastic things now.
Not about me. I want to talk about him.
Yeah, talk about him. Yes, tell me what he's doing.
So my dad started he's an educationalist as well. So he comes from a really backward area called Rayalaseema.
Yes.
Where there is not a lot of water. And when my dad started making money as an actor, he wanted to give back to the place that he came from. So he chose a place in Rayalaseema, 14 kilometers from Tirupati, to start a small school, to in turn give it back. When he started the school, a lot of his colleagues told him, why are you going and putting money in a place where there's no water even, it's all just rocks. If you put that same money in Hyderabad, you'll make so much more money. He said, no, I'm going to give back to the society. He's the only man in India, again, to have his prospectus not have the column for caste. All schools accept that you need to write your father's name, your mother's name, what is your caste. He's the only school in the prospectus where there is no caste, that it's removed. We need that after you get accepted into the school. He says, what if in general somebody who's the people who are accepting the students because of the same caste, that they'll give him better preference. So nobody knows what caste the student is when they come in, number one. Number two, he gives 25% free education irrespective of their caste increased if they come from a
backward
community of not being able to fulfill their dreams as a student. We have about over 14,000 students in his school and engineering colleges. About 4,000 of them get aid in some form or the other, from their toothbrushes to their school fees, and some just in different intermediates. What else? And he says education is the only danam that you can do that you cannot take away. I can give you money and you'll want money. I can give you food and you'll want food. But if I give you education, I cannot take it back.
What a wonderful way to end this program. May there be many more like you, Mohan Babu, who come from the roots, rise to the top, and then give back to society. It's been wonderful talking to you, Lakshmi and Mohan Babu. Thank you very much for joining us on India Today, India Tomorrow.
And we are also very happy having such a personality in front of us, like an actor. And
I must tell you, before the program, Mohan Babu says I should have been an actor.
And
but
sir,
maybe that's what I do on television.
You have good diction and the wave, the style and personality.
And you like my nose.
And eyes
he
also.
He believes a good actor must have a good nose.
Eyes also.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. This has now become a mutual admiration society. But thank you very much for joining us. That's it on India Today, India Tomorrow. Hope you liked it. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.